As we go to air tonight, residents in Kangaroo Island's Vivonne Bay are being evacuated from their homes. Authorities concerned dangerous conditions tomorrow could see the bushfire that's already caused so much devastation jump containment lines.
A desperate battle on the eve of another dangerous day. Flames rage out of control in tinder-dry scrub near Stokes Bay. A heli tanker providing support from above as those on the ground fight to protect properties.
We're just trying to use our own loader and a couple of other private stuff to push brake down in front of my grandpa's place. The more the burns today, the better, probably. Put it out for tomorrow.
It's flare-ups like this that have everyone concerned about tomorrow. The forecast hot and windy conditions, prompting authorities to take the drastic step of evacuating the entire town of Vivonne Bay.
We think if the fire does get up and run tomorrow and breaks control lines, our ability to protect them in that particular environment, given the fuel loads that are there, is extremely limited.
Police pleading with people to cooperate.
People won't be dragged from their homes, but they need to be aware this is not a drill.
The warnings coming after the Prime Minister visited the fire ground today.
How you doing? You good?
Meeting with those who've already experienced the bushfire's fury.
We lost everything. Home, sheds, a native bush garden that was open to the public. But my brothers also lost their properties.
Simon and Madeline Kelly losing 6,000 sheep, their shearing shed and equipment.
We've still got a house to live in. Most of my neighbours are homeless. Like, it's just devastating. We're lucky.
The federal and state government committing another $11 million to help farmers and businesses. The Prime Minister urging everyone to get behind those on the island.
It's very important as part of the recovery that we rebuild the local economies as much as we will rebuild the local infrastructure.
While the recovery mission is well underway, the main focus tonight is on the immediate threat, with extra crews arriving on the island ready for tomorrow's fight. Ella Duffy, Nine News.
Let's go straight to Jessica Braithwaite now. Jessica, what more do we know about the weather conditions for tomorrow?
Well, forecasters are expecting seven different shifts in wind direction on Kangaroo Island as three separate weather systems move across the state in one day tomorrow. Now, those multiple changes in wind direction will make things extremely complex on the fire ground, especially on that southern flank of the blaze. Firefighters and locals have worked tirelessly to bolster their defences, but the hot and windy conditions are making the fire activity hard to predict. Kangaroo Island is one of six South Australian districts with a severe fire danger and total fire bans tomorrow, including here in the Mount Lofty Ranges. But the change will ease conditions on Friday, bringing much-needed rain.